Hey viewers, Peter here. Thank you so much for watching, and I would like to assure you the privacy rights. Please send us your questions, your concerns, or something you'd like us to illustrate more when it comes to the knowledge of law and also the understanding of the justice system. This is following, or it is a continuum from the previous video that we have already presented. Now, C being the complainant, he's the one instituting the entire lawsuit against the offender, who in this case is D. Now, when C has to take what we call the lawsuit against D, he has to ensure so many things. First and foremost, it must be within the precincts of law. It must be within the jurisdiction of the court. It must be truthful. It must be fact-based, and it can be scientifically verified. It can be observed. It can be proved through evidence known as documentary evidence, or evidence through eyewitnesses, or evidence of any kind that is approved by the court. Once said and done by C through his lawyer or maybe in person, then you can now proceed to the court. The courts have got the registrar's office where everything is filed, and after filing, it will be now upon the court to institute for you the so-called the court, in this case. And instituting the court must be done after proving that the case has got merit in this particular court. When we talk of court, we are not talking about the building. We are talking about a judge presiding over a matter involving two parties. The parties must only be two, not even two and a half. And in this case, C versus D. That is against. Why do we say versus D? It is versus D in the sense that we are in an adversarial system in which one person is in dispute with another person, and the other person must be defending himself or herself before the court. So it becomes a litigation or a dispute, and it is not a dispute as a quarrel in a lay term language, but it's a dispute in the sense of law and justice system, in which the right to be heard, the right to be tried is guaranteed. And in this case, the process of law, or what we call the due process, is followed. Rules are there, and once admitted in court, then the court is the one to summon the defendant, not the C. So defendant will be summoned in writing, and summon will be served to him at the convenient allowed time. Don't serve such things outside the legal time. Don't serve the summon at midnight in somebody's private home. That would be, again, violation of the procedure. Now, again, back to procedures. We are talking about the civil procedure. We are talking about civil offenses. These are offenses that are not criminal. Now, once the court has issued summon, it is now under obligation, or it is the duty of D to appear in court as an established material time as presented within the summon. Then he will be told about why the court needs his presence or her presence. That means every person must be told the charges against him or against her. In this case, we are talking about the lawsuit. Then it is now upon D to present himself or herself on that material day, at that particular time, in court and before a judge. Thank you for watching. We'll continue with this series. follow us.